Universal drilling fluids and solids control has been the million-dollar idea. How do we maximize a fluid that can drill multiple formations in a solids control unit and continue to drill and maintain this low solids, you know, 8.8 mud weight and lower, and get to total depth fast, efficient? If it's bringing water out of the ground, bringing water or installing product or bringing out minerals, whatever it is, we're always thinking about how can we do it easier. Well, engineered drilling fluids is the key. You know, talking to your local mud engineers, your mud companies, finding what fluids work best, and then understanding your equipment and how it's going to react. You know, linear shakers are going to allow us to run more PHPA polymers at a higher concentration than an elliptical. If I know I'm going to be in sands and gravels, the fluid that I'm building, I need it to have good filtration control, and then suddenly I'm going to be in dense clay and I don't need a heavy bentonite fluid or a viscous bentonite fluid because I already have this clay and I need to maintain my good uphole velocities. You know, it comes back to how do I build this fluid? One of the best advances we have, and they've been around a long time, are medium yield bentonites, so that I can put enough bentonite in the system that'll help me carry cuttings out of the hole, stabilize that borehole without giving me a ton of viscosity. And then I can use that. I have this base of this fluid that I just built, and now I can start adding in my filtration control polymers and my PHPAs and engineer a fluid that can go from sands and gravels into clays or shales and then back. And then understanding that even though I built these fluids and I have this volume, that those polymers and bentonites are depleting out. And the hardest thing we have with mixed soils and solids control units is we want to mix all of our drilling fluid into our solids control unit. We have solids control units. They're designed to recycle drilling fluids and separate solids. Their secondary function and a convenience to you was to be able to mix drilling fluids in them. So you either need a pre-mixed tank that's built on the system, or you have to have one that's got a horse tank alongside, or you have a secondary pit that I'm building my drilling fluid in, and I'm adding that in. So I'm adding in whole fluids that are completely yielded out, not yielded out, completely ready for you to drill with, that aren't blinding shaker screens or getting separated out by the cones, and they're going back down hole. So if you want to be successful in mixed geologies with a solids control unit, it's engineering your drilling fluid, understanding your shakers and what the limitations are to polymers, and then building all of that together and maximizing my drilling parameters. So how is my bit cutting? What is my uphole velocities? Am I keeping solids intact? And is my pickup pump picking this stuff up and separating it? And then how long before I have to add more polymers or bentonite to my system? And understanding that as I drill, I'm leaving fluid in the hole and I'm making a wall cake and I have to put more bentonite in that system to stay active. So the biggest thing about mixed geologies and engineered drilling fluids is get a simple super slurry kit and have sand content, funnel viscosity, and mud density right there so you can see those. And then if you're really curious, get a great mud engineer out on site and have him run Geologies and filtrate, and really, or her, and find out really what's going on that job site.